All right. So yeah, this is the Project Mountain Climber. Massive rover. And right now I'm getting 40. Wow, actually pretty good on the FPS, but it seems to be pretty damn low. So yeah. I'm gonna make sure I'm gonna grab an updated blueprint of this. I don't think I'm actually going to work on this part of the design. I'm going to be working on a tiny little rover based off of this bottom wheel section down there. That's going to be used to lift, get lifted up and down. It's going to basically be the transport vehicle. Delete that and instant sim speed. Now the question is, do I have wheel section, because I think I got a blueprint of the wheel section. No, this is the old wheel block crap. All right. Right, well. And instantly. Goodbye. Delete you. That went sideways. And also, why are you rolling away? You should have more than enough max friction. Good enough. This is how many blocks? Four blocks from the center. Okay, they are even good. Actually, this might be pretty damn tiny. I might have to edit the design of this, so I didn't realize how small it would be. That off. Oh, okay. Dive forward. Measure from here out. Yep. And blocks over. Am I close? Wow, that close. Alright, main wheels are set. I don't actually know how well this will work when I scale it down. Also, crap, they're on the right height. Oh shit, these do mirror right. But they didn't. Alright, now for the tiny wheels. Think. Do I want to do this one? You know what? I'm gonna try just a completely new design. I don't know how well this will translate to tiny, to small ship. I also want to use that rotor script. Actually, this rotor in my bar. It's like, dude, big as that. Got two blocks. Actually, I should be using piping for this, because that's the reason why I'm using an advanced rotor. Actually, do I need advanced rotor for this? No, you know what? I don't need advanced rotor for this. Right, no power. It doesn't actually control panel on small grids. Please. Alright, now I can set lower limit negative 30 degrees. Let's try. Oh god. Twenty works. Wow. How big these wheels are. And these are too small for what I want to do. Alright. So I have no idea how cars actually, suspension actually work. A Colt command console is available for small ships. They are. Ooh. I have a prog block. There it is. Edit, browse scripts. Ah. All right. How the hell do I use this? Name the rotor spring. Default target angle, I want negative 25. Alright. Rotor not found. Custom data. There it is. And I said 20, not 25. Good enough. Edit. Let's start with a zero on there. Hey, Grim Reaper, what's up, man? Just doing a bit of late night streaming. Oh, I just keep adding zeros till it works. This is gonna need a lot more torque. Here's that one too. Why can't I set this torque up higher? I want to set it up higher. More zeros. Toggle off for a second. What if I set the torque? How many zeros is that again? Three, five. Three, six. Three, nine. Let's try 45. Four. All right, turn you on. Damn it. I don't remember how this thing works. I don't know if you guys can see shift tab for me looking in the workshop, but alright, spring and custom data of the rotor. Wait for a while, press recompile. All right. Shoot. Let's start a couple zeros. See what happens. Oh, current angle negative 13. That's good. Still not strong enough to get myself back up. Oh, target angle, right. let's make this 0 degrees, see what happens. No idea. No idea how this script works. Alright, let's make that 20. 10. 1? No idea how this thing works. Turn off right now. Oh, 44,000. I need to add in another script. This is just set and go. Well, let's go. I'm drifting. Ice plane's probably not the best spot for this. Turn the friction. Ooh. Everything's fine. Okay, I need a wider wheelbase. Frack, I just deleted it again. Doesn't matter, I need a wider wheelbase. Nope, I need that one on. 44,000. Speed's fine. You're off. Control C. So, why did you place properly but not you? Genius. Shit, that was in the way. These do not need to steer. Nine, 20 degrees is a bit too much, anyways. Try 15. There we It's working. Get rid of this. This is going to become a bed of a pickup truck. Which is why I wanted the extra spring in the back, so when it's carrying a heavy load, it would be fine. And where are the med blocks? Right, these things are ridiculously large. You know what? I kind of want to do something a little stupid. Oh no, you know what? If I'm gonna make this lift with a with the crane, I can't do that. Never mind. Shit. I was gonna put a crane in the middle. Can't do that. Just gonna get lifted up. Do I have the folding landing gear mod on this world? No. No, that does work. It just doesn't open and close. Damn. Well, actually, no, I can do. Button mashing. It's not all that button mashing. I'm going to turn off the HUD. The heavy armor bed down. Sidewalls back. Hey, Torgonator, what's up? Just working on little flatbed truck type thing for the mountain climber, which I have deleted because, man, that thing just causes too much lag. No one. Do I not have connectors on my bar? Damn. Why do I not have connectors? Alright. Get out of here, fence. And I don't need cover walls right now either. Ah, well, good morning, Torg, then. Yeah, it's pretty late night for me, so. Oops, that's not a spot. Oh, and then this is gonna need its own power unit, isn't it? Battery's gonna be too freaking big. Ooh. Unless. Oh wait, I need a rotor head. You know what, I'm gonna move that actually back another 2 blocks. Get out of here, tear apart. I think this is a genius idea. Just, you know, add another subgrid to the list of subgrids on this world. That's how I want to leave. Alright, rotor 5. Oh, you can't edit rotor displacement. There's a head on it, I did not know that. There we go, got a battery. You know what? Forklift! Get out here. I have a feeling this is gonna clang a lot. Now, assuming I've put the rotor in the right spot. Delete this one, so that's what's happening. Damn it, I didn't put the rotor in the right spot. Bit of a lag spike there. Oh my God. Please just stop. Gonna push it. There we go. That seems like it fits. Oh, get ready for some clang. Let's turn off damage. Oh, wow. There was zero clang. That is surprising. Alright, I should turn this rotor off. So center yourself, please. And rotor lock. Actually, you know what? I should probably make this. You know what, it's fine. I said I put a connector on both sides, but. It's just fine. Mm-hmm. these don't just, they don't have the same effect of large ground down ones. These don't work as well. It's a large ship version. I use that normally all the time. Lights. And there's no button panels. They're like full on size button panels. Also, this connector. Turn your strength to disabled. Not nothing like using ladders for something you don't even need ladders for. Alright, for a little cargo crate in the back, that's pretty good. Alright, got the battery. I'm gonna make the actual cab itself. Seeing as this might not make it, or may not always be on a planet, or on an atmospheric planet, should I say? Throw that on there. I'll make this wider. I can't even make it wider. Do you have any to fix this? This also needs a ramming bar in the front. Those are tiny wheels. Still the wrong wheels. And I won't place the wheel because it's too close. Try another block out. And of course. These things didn't mirror properly. Actually, this is gonna come forward one more block. Do that before I actually destroy the entire thing. You know, are there any better blocks for this? This is for damn, it's only for large ship. Only for large ship. It's spotlights. I don't want those there. How big are cult command consoles? Okay, the steering. Or do anything. I wonder. I don't have small ship windows. Look at that hollow for right now. Oh, no, not that. Not there. First spot would be this. Maybe. Dock on this. This is him, and do I have a small ship door? That's perfect. Pair of lockers. Wait, the suit locker. I don't know why you would need it. This cab is pretty small. I could always increase the size of this. That gives me an extra block on the inside and on this side for some railings. Now, question, can a character, yes, your SC character can walk through this, but not this. Damn it. Oh, wait. This isn't gonna pressure seal anyways. So never mind, get rid of you. I like the idea of having that on the side there. Shit. Oops. Probably two. Probably the two left ones. Strength. Yeah, it is. Zero friction. And no steering, no propulsion. Ooh, I should do the tank steering. Why are the back wheels out further? That out of the floor. Here. Small cargo container access. Right there. Oh shit. An oxygen vent right there. But damn, this isn't being pressurized. So then I'm gonna do the front end. Oh shit, I didn't mean to do that. Don't ram cars in my bar, whatever. You know what, I'm gonna experiment with using this. So use this. And get an oxygen seal. That door is so tiny. There's no way my engineer fits in there. The good news is I do get in and out right here. Like, God, that's tiny. Yeah, nope. Not doing it. No idea what I'm doing with the front end of this either. Actually, wait, I gotta test the height of this thing. You know what? We're gonna pretend. You can pressurize this thing. So yeah, for those of you who've never seen this before, Insta-lag. Oh, wait, you know what I need to do? Other than stop lagging. Holy shit. And by the way, this is why I'm not building with that thing in the world. Nor would I ever stream this. But for right now, everybody can deal with it. How does this work? Does the skid steel work through rotors? I don't remember. Right, I need gyroscopes on this for this kid's ear work. I think, or does it just, I have to group name it, I don't remember. It's been a long time since I used the script. That needs to go away. Where's auto cruise? You know what? I'll just figure all that out later. Right now, steering, which ones are you? You are the back wheels. Oh yeah, I got more than enough height on this. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Ah, that'll buff out. So yeah, basically how this entire crane setup works. Assuming the blocks didn't fuse themselves together and become a single grid, because that keeps happening. Press that button. You can imagine I would have grabbed onto like a cargo container or a couple vehicles or something. And then eventually it'll have this all controlled by one button panel. Just one press of a button. So like if you wanna lower it for cargo container, press this button. If you wanna lower it for vehicle, press this button. If you wanna raise it for cargo container, press this button, et cetera, like that. For right now, I've got so you can see it's pretty slow, but it works. I mean, this is also has to do with the 0.4 sim speed right now. It's also that button. It's been a while since I've worked on this. So yeah, basically there's gonna be a massive hangar bay here. Think aircraft carrier mixed with oil rig. Runway section right here. Main bridge. Some gas storage in the, over there. But yeah. Time to get rid of this. Gonna put windows in here, but actually I could do one. Boom, instant window. Try to do one. No, if I did a window, I don't think I could walk through here. I won't be able to walk through there, so. Yeah, from first person, you know, we get that kind of view. Oh, I love that. What do you mean? Oh. Yes, that would make sense. We're just gonna pretend that this room can be pressurized. like that. I'm just gonna go with regular suspension, yeah. Which cannot be placed. There, place it now. Don't tell me it can't be placed. That actually reminds me, I need to go in here and add some pistons. I mean, yes, you heard me right. Add pistons. I know, it's crazy. This is the same height, correct? Yes, they are. These ones are a bit more difficult. Yeah. Although, would I even need a piston lift those? Going up. There we go. There we go. That works. God. And that's why you turn off damage, everyone. Alright, yeah, see you later, Torg. Turn the power down, increase strength a little bit, and offset friction. Alright. Woo, spinning out! Definitely can use some gyros. Yes. definitely needs gyros. Don't like using gyros in rovers, but not gonna lie, they do make SE a lot easier to run or drive vehicles in. And I'm gonna have to fix those back wheels. Actually, I might extend out the wheel frame a bit. First person driving. Let's try that out. So apparently snow is slippery. Who would have guessed? Hill climbing, rough terrain hill climbing to be exact. Come on. Nah, it doesn't have the strength, damn it. Increase the power just a bit. Not strength. Increase power, decrease power, restriction. There we go. Oops. That's a slight issue. And if I didn't have damage off, that would have caused an explosion. But that's why you do all your first testing with damage off. Alright, now no, wait, actually I should get a blueprint of this. Yeah. And time to allow some damage. First thing I do is flip it. Didn't break though when I flipped it, that's a good sign. See, I'm gonna decrease the speed limit on these wheels. is a bit fast. Let's go with highway speeds. That was slower than highway speed. I don't even really need the torsion spring script anyway, running at all. Not really. I think I need to add a bit more torque to that rotor though. And I'll probably just have it on a slider bar, so they're on a button panel, so I can increase it and decrease it based on the weight of the truck. Handle that little bump nicely. Oh, and I got stuck. That's the one problem with tiny little wheeled vehicles. Yeah, stuck in everything. Boost the friction on these wheels. Come on. Come on. Oh, I'm surprised that didn't cause any damage. Max power. Full power to the engines. There we go, got out. We're down to 50% friction. Oh, Oh, balls, I just lose the internet. Hold on a second. Am I gonna lost internet? Not sure. I bet her Discord just went down. No, my internet seems fine. All right, whatever. Okay, but something's causing some lag on my computer. Because OBS is dropping frames. I'm gonna try and do a restart of Space Engineers. I'm just gonna drive this back down the hill and see if that helps OBS. Because it keeps dropping recording speed to like 19 frames per second. When the game is clearly running at 40. And I use the word clearly very loosely. As this is SE, and those numbers in the top right left corner have been known to lie. Let's take a fast down this hill. All recording at 19 frames per second. Whoa! Seriously, sorry about this. Watch out for that tree. I got this. Well, that survived. Oh, I'm watching on the stream right now and that laggy, choppy. Yeah, alright. Let me save game. Window. Right. Steam. Let me check my phone, see if Discord's just down. It seems like Discord's down. There we go. Let's back up. Had this problem in the past with recording with the OBS or recording space with OBS where it would just randomly drop frames on recording even though in game I was way over 30 FPS. It's weird. OBS is the only recording software I've had that seems to have that issue. Okay, space engineers, are you okay? Space engineers just crash on me. Nope, it came back. Hey, there we go. It's alive. Or not. There you go. No. I'm just maybe wondering if it's just recording at. Yeah, no, it's recording at shitty FPS again. But it could be just because the world's loading in. Seems to be good. Now it's dropping again. Creation data, there it is. Okay, yeah, nope. Even just sitting still and not looking at anything, it's jumping between 19 and 30 FPS. I don't know what's doing this. Could be a memory leak with OBS or something. I don't know. Did it wipe? It fucking wipe my hotbars. You son of a bitch. Do you know how long it takes me to set my freaking hotbars in the perfect position? Very long time. Suck, I see. Oh god, yeah, I'm looking at the stream right now and it's choppy as all fuck. Alright. I'm just gonna sit still so you guys don't have to deal with that choppiness. I'm gonna end the stream here and try and figure out what the hell is going on. And plus it's 1:30 in the morning. So, yeah. Alright. Have a good night, everyone. Bye.